one lane for these drivers. Let's see how everybody will fare over the course of this one. Here is Toby Bundo. Well, he's got a bit of not a lot of time really to sort this one out. This will be his final fight lap of the session. He's going to be praying with all of his might that it is a good lap as well.
Well, Seth, he's not really been the same since his regional final win in Tokyo so many months ago, but he hasn't quite come back from that. Big bike on the top. Seth's new time goes second to 1:13.8. Is now Karanza goes from the sixth place to 1:21.3. The same Pokemon comes in 1:21.6, and then Pokemon comes in at the last minute, goes to 4th to 1:31.1. Now, what can Igor Fraga do? He's down in 8th position, actually quite far from pace right now, 3 steps off top.
Yeah, he's had a real shock in here so far, as the Brazilian driver, Adam Brooks, comes over the line, he finishes in 10th position, personal best lap time here, but here is Igor Fraga with an all to do, over the line comes the Brazilian, and he goes to the front row in 2nd place, right at the very end of that session. Absolutely fantastic stuff for Igor Fraga, right when he needed it to do it. Lopez, the not improved. He ends up 4th position at the end of the qualifying for the Nations Cup.
Yeah, very good for Friday. I think we get nervous with him there, seeing quite being up in the top four. Second place for now. Anyone else to improve?
Very impressive stuff indeed. I think all the drivers who are on personal best lap times aren't going to be looking to improve, but I'd say that they're probably just about that, because Rubelar, meanwhile, he is fast. It's quite comfortably in the session by nearly 4 tenths, over 4 tenths, and a second as a matter of fact. He's got a couple more corners to negotiate, and that will be the checkered flag here for the first Rubelar. Rubelar takes it off the Chilean. Can he improve over the rest of the drivers? Over the line he comes. It's not an improvement, but it's still fastest in that session. What about Ferranza then? The Brazilian out of the final corner. He comes. Can he improve on 8th place? Over the line he goes. 7th position at the checkered flag then for Brazil. For Ferranza, he doesn't make it into that top 6 qualifying for tomorrow, Jimmy.
That's what I'm saying. Just stuck in there for the last 6th position. So we'll be happy with that. But very interesting to see that.
Grosse foule, hein.
Gilets jaunes.
Alors Paris le samedi, c'est comment dire, tranquille. Alors on est arrivé un peu à l'avance. On est au centre de la FIA à Paris.
Oups, j'ai raté un appel de mon patron.
Et pour l'instant, voilà, on a réussi à se faufiler parce qu'il y a pas mal de barrages.
Historical headquarters, which is Ville Place de la Concorde. I will give you a little of a background of history later. As you can see here, we are celebrating through the FIA Hall of Fame the world champions of our most prestigious competitions. Last year, we inducted the Formula One world champions. So on the left side for me, on your right side for you, on this wall, you have since 1950 all the winners which have been recognized, and this year we have been starting recognizing the World Rally champions with a co-driver. So it is for us a way to celebrate the glorious records of those championships. That place is completely open to public, so everybody can come and visit. And if you like, you have small brochures close to the screens, which are referring to the WRC last induction session we had. I would like now to invite you, so we go up to the fifth floor where we have our salut committee. I have a sporting option for you, which is taking the stairs. It's a good morning wake-up, you know. Many people like to, you know, to stretch the audience.
Is there a virtual option?
No, exactly. Well, virtual can stay here, then we text you. You will see on the walls of the staircase that we are remembering all the FIA presidents. So you have them from 1904 up to current days with Jean-Todd being the current president. And you also have the presidents of the CSI, which was the Comité Sportif International, which was specifically in charge of motorsport regulation for a couple of years. So if you can kindly follow me, we will be delighted to go through.
Sachant que derrière ils sont mis dehors,
ouais. Mitsu, j'ai bien son relais.
Ouais, très bien. Je pense typiquement faut mettre les médiums maintenant et finir en hard.
Finir en hard, ouais. Ah, ils ont pas le choix.
Pour enfoncer le clou et être vraiment à l'abri et faire de la gestion avec les hards.
Ou alors tu mets un hard pour faire deux tours.
On est d'accord que la Renault elle est pas stable du tout. Hein. C'est un cauchemar. Pour l'instant, la Porsche, mine de rien, elle est bien montée aussi. Oh, bien joué!
Oh, il lui a mis un inté. Les petites familles.
Alors, qu'est-ce que ça donne? Ça donne que t'es cadré très serré. T'es cadré très serré. On pourrait peut-être voir l'Aston gagner, non? Merci. Merci quand même. Bravo.
But his team, Aston Martin!